Hello, welcome to the Wednesday, October 27th, 2021 edition of the Sands and Storm Centers Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich and I'm recording from Al Khobar, Saudi Arabia. Apple released its new operating system, Monterey, and with that we got a number of security updates. Sad part is, we don't really know what security vulnerabilities are being fixed. It states on Apple's security updates page that there will be details released shortly, so maybe by tomorrow we do have some more details. This also affects iOS, watchOS, tvOS, and iPadOS. All of these operating systems have been updated, and there was also a security update for macOS Big Sur, but then again, no details available at this point. It's also noteworthy that if you received a new Mac this week that had a macOS Monterey pre-installed, there is also an update for you, macOS Monterey 12.01, which is the version that was then released for download, does include additional security updates. And according to a blog post by researchers from Inky, it looks like Craigslist may be subject to some form of breach that allowed an attacker to send email on Craigslist's behalf. The emails in question are only sent to active Craigslist users, and they originated from an IP address that is actually associated with Craigslist and did pass SPF and DKIM checks. I haven't seen anything from Craigslist about this incident. Of course, there's always a chance that they may have just abused the internal messaging function or something like this. The emails themselves claimed that the recipient had listed an item that was inappropriate for Craigslist, provided a link to remedy the issue, and that link then led to, well, possibly malware. The Inky researchers were not able to retrieve the last step here because the link was returning a 404 error, so not really clear if maybe the malware was taken down or what really the actual purpose was of these emails. A little bit odd that someone who would be able to actually compromise the email system of a popular site like Craigslist would not be able to then find a place to host their malware reliably. And Jakub Wawra with Avast did post a blog post with details regarding UltimaSMS. UltimaSMS is Android malware that is actually distributed via the Google Play Store and looks like some of the applications may still be available. About 151 apps were identified as part of this particular campaign. They're being advertised via Instagram and TikTok channels and promise photo editors, camera filters, game, and various other apps. What's sort of interesting is that many of them are being installed here in the Middle East, and well, while they counted about 80 countries, the vast majority was installed in Egypt, Saudi Arabia, Pakistan, and the United Arab Emirates. The blog post does talk about a few million installs of these applications, and once the user installs them, the application will sign them up for premium SMS services. Now, I think what makes these scams somewhat popular and successful is that they actually customize the scam page to the language of the user based on the phone number and other indicators from the Android operating system. And Mozilla disclosed that it removed back in June two extensions for Firefox from its web store that took advantage of Firefox's Proxy API in order to prevent Firefox from updating. Whenever there's an update for Firefox, Google Chrome, and so on, I usually mention that, well, these browsers are pretty good at updating themselves, so usually not much you can do. They will continuously check for updates if they're available, and then apply them as needed. However, the proxy API was able to intercept these requests and then, of course, block them in these cases. The result is now that Mozilla is getting tighter on applications that are taking advantage of this proxy API. Also, they are excluding requests for updates from the proxy API, so they may no longer be intercepted using any add-ons. Well, that's it for today. So thanks again for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.